Will Senator yield for some questions on education issues?
Yes.
Senator yields.
Thank you, Senator. Can you outline in very general terms how the Senate majority modifies the executive's budget regarding overall funding for education? Just the skeletal outline of funding.
Certainly, Senator. In our One House budget resolution, the Senate puts forward year-to-year increase of $1.6 billion, and basically that is comprised of three major things. First of all, it has been this chamber that has fought so hard to fully get rid of the gap elimination adjustment, which members in this House know was passed in 2009 and 10, and it was something that many of my colleagues on my side of the aisle, actually all of them, voted against. Unfortunately, was forced through. It's a fiscal gimmick that basically gives funding to our school districts on one hand, and on the other hand, claws it back, takes it away. It has hurt the learning opportunities for our children across the state ever since it was put into place. And that's why we feel so strongly about getting rid of the gap elimination for good. We include $434 million to fully eliminate the gap elimination adjustment this year, not over 2 years, as the governor would like to do, but fully get rid of it this year. On top of it, we have about $880 million put forward for foundation aid. That's a significant number. And then the rest of the budget has to do with expense-driven aids.
Will the senator continue to yield?
Yes.
Senator yields.
Thank you. The $1.65 billion in the aggregate represents about $700,000 more than the governor's $991 million. And if that is true, and the restoration of GEA, which I have supported and the majority of my colleagues on this side of the aisle have voted for when it's come before us, represents about $244 million additional money in order to fully repeal GEA out of what appears to be, unless I'm mistaken, $700,000 more in spending. So if that is true, if those numbers are accurate, there's about $450 million additional money, and I'd like to see if you can highlight, Senator, how that $450 million is allocated vis-a-vis foundation aid.
Certainly, Mr. President, through you. And so earlier in the discussion when Senator Krueger got up and spoke and asked questions, we went over this information, but I don't mind going through it again. Basically, we have been able to do several things in regards to the executive budget proposal. And we have exact cuts that we put forward in spending that he would like to do, and that's to the tune of $45 million in state operations. We also implement $484 million in targeted reductions and reprogramming actions, and those include reestimates, including $35 million from retirement vacancy savings, $300 million from a personal services spending base reestimate, and when you put that with the fact that there was a consensus on the revenue agreement that we just had of $225 million, and as you know, that was a three-way agreement that there was $225 million extra to spend, and also we would put forward $53 million in settlement funds. That gives us the ability to fund eliminating the gap elimination adjustment this year and actually add to foundation aid.
Thank you. Will the senator continue to yield?
Yes.
Senator yields.
Thank you. One of the repurposings that appears to be in this is a elimination of $100 million for community schools. What was the Senate majority's rationale for that elimination?
Okay. Through you, Mr. President. Actually, we don't eliminate it. It's still within the foundation aid formula.
If the senator will continue to yield?
Yes.
So within that foundation formula addition, there is already actually $100 million that would be used for community schools. Is that officially targeted as such, or will that be something that will reduce what non-targeted community school foundation aid would be?
Through you, Mr. President. Foundation aid is operating aid, so to establish a community school, for example, there's $100 million that could be part of the foundation aid formula, and those are all local decisions.
Thank you. There's other questions to be asked, but I'm afraid time being of the essence, I'll just ask one more question with the indulgence of the president and the senator. The changes to charter school operations in the Senate majority's resolution is rather dramatic. Can you explain what the function and the structure of those changes are?
Thank you, Mr. President, through you. Basically, what the budget resolution would do would be to allow charter schools to continue to operate at a high level and service as public schools children across the state.
If the senator will yield.
Certainly.
Senator,
thank you.
Sponsor yields to an additional question.
I think we'll try to get a little more specificity on that as we go to the conference committees. It's a very important policy issue. Another important policy issue is whether or not there are any resources targeted to districts that have an increase in ELL students. Does the Senate majority make any provision in this resolution for that purpose?
Through you, Mr. President, that actually is accounted for in the foundation aid.
Mr. President, Madam Senator, thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.
Thank you, Senator Latimer.